Hi and welcome to this tutorial for Fastlane Digital Audio School done in Montpellier, France, an Ableton certified training center. Today I'm really proud to introduce to you the Push Hacker 2. This Max for Life device is the result of the collaboration between sound manufacturer and Fastlane. Push Hacker 2 has been recorded from the ground up to make it more powerful and more flexible than ever. Push Hacker 2 enables you to assign or reassign any feature on the push whilst in note or session mode. So you will be able to customize your push whilst retaining that strong integration we find in note or session mode. To use Push Hacker 2, you need a MIDI track. So I'm going to now create a MIDI track here and drop the Push Hacker directly onto it. You can rename that track if you need. I'm going to do that. Push Hacker, of course. Here we go, that way. So the interface of Push Hacker opens immediately and recognizes if you've attached Push 1 or Push 2 to the computer. But if you unplug your push and the Push Hacker loses the connection, you can always click on this button here, Rescan Push, to re-enable the communication. So the virtual push interface here on the left-hand side of Push Hacker 2 enables you to choose which controls, which features you'd like to hack. All the hacks you'll do will work in note or session mode, and they will be kept across these two modes. So as you probably know, in session mode, you can launch clips and launch scenes here on the right-hand side, and you may want to hack, for example, the two top rows here on the matrix. So I'm going to choose the top left pad here. Look, it turned yellow. And I'm now going to choose within the 7 functions here on the right hand side to hack that feature. So we're going to look at most of the functions here in this tutorial, but I'll keep the clip function for the next tutorial. So the first function we're going to talk about is the map function. So first of all, at the top there, you'll notice that the pad you chose on the virtual push is now listed here. You can assign up to 8 different parameters using these map buttons. So to start with, I'm going to choose and click one of the send dials. So now when I trigger the pad on push, that send is going up and down. I can choose the minimum and maximum value for each of these mappings, and I can invert their values using this I button here. Let's go and assign another parameter, for example, this volume fader here. And I can now control both these parameters using one pad on my push. I can determine the color of the pad when the function is on and its color when the function is off. You see now the color on the pad has changed. Each of the functions you'll use on the Push Hacker 2 will let you send a message on the push screen. This actually could be quite convenient to remember what you actually assigned to each of the features of your push. So now when I use the pad, you'll see a message appears on push's screen. Let's now go and choose another feature on push, for example, that button below the screen here. And I'll demonstrate another function, the clip grid. The pad matrix at the center of your push, as you may know, appears in live as a square around your clips in the session view. So basically that square, which is red in this instance, will show you which zone of your clips push can actually control. It's quite common to make that red square move during a performance using that top cursor here. But when you need to move that square far away from its actual position, it's quite inconvenient to press that cursor many times and it's also not very precise. So using this function, we'll be able to send that square to a very specific location we have predetermined. So I'm now going to select one of the locations in live, for example, at the top left corner here, and then press the Learn button. Let's now choose another feature of push and assign the clip grid function to it as well, and choose a different location in the session view in live. So when I now use both these buttons in turn, you can see the red square jumps to the locations I previously chose. This is well convenient, so we don't have to press many times that cursor to move from one tune to another in a live set. And it's also way more precise. You see the square jumps exactly where we want it to go. So whilst in the 7 clip grid function, I can choose up to 4 different locations. So now if I choose a different location in live and I press the Learn button, you'd see the red square jumps in turn to the different locations I chose. So this feature obviously maximizes the space on your push, but it's also quite convenient to jump to different sections of the same tune, for example. Let's now choose one of the dials at the top of the virtual push here. These features can only be assigned to one type of function, the curve function. So once again, you'll be able to assign up to 4 parameters in live. These could be in the mixing section or even on your effects. So for example, let's first assign the frequency on that auto filter. Using the graph here, I can now determine the movement of that parameter over time. So for example, the filter will go up rapidly first and then lower back down to go back up again towards the end of the dial. I'm now going to assign a different parameter to the second map button. I'm now going to select its curve using these buttons here. And let's program this so it only goes up towards the very end of the dial. I can also adjust its minimum and maximum value. Now, when I turn the dial, you'll see these parameters behave exactly like I programmed them on the graph. And these behaviors apply upwards and downwards, of course. Those of you who know Mapulator, which was released a few months ago, will recognize its interface here in PushHacker. It has been integrated within PushHacker. On the top right-hand side of this function, you have a master control, which enables you to try the mappings you've done, to try the graphs, see if they fit your needs. Those of you who possess a push will know that these dials on the top of the instrument will send a MIDI note message as soon as you touch them. Well, we can also assign this behavior to the push hacker with this button here on the right hand side. So if I here assign a send dial, you see I'll only need to touch the dial on push to activate this parameter. Let's now go and hack the play button on the bottom left corner of push here, so I can demonstrate the set track function. Using this function, you can select a particular track in your live set. So I'm now going to select this track and click the learn selected track button here. This function is especially useful in the note mode, so you can basically trigger the instrument on the track. We could, for example, imagine the bottom left corner of your push only dedicated to record specific tracks, so you can select the lead or the bass during the live set and play them live. I'm now going to hack the left part of the bottom cursor here on push to demonstrate the solo function. Simply choose the name of the track and click the select track button here. When I now trigger this feature on push, you can see this track is going into solo mode. For now, it's in the toggle behavior. I only need to hit the toggle button here on the push hacker to turn it into a gate momentary behavior. Now, when I let go my finger, the track goes off solo mode. Each of the functions, each of the hacks you've made on your push can be assigned to a specific group. You can choose within 4 different groups. So by assigning these functions to groups, you'll be able to activate and deactivate the whole of these functions at once. So for example, let's go and choose the tap button here on the top left corner of push and assign it to the on-off function here. I can here determine which group this button will activate and deactivate. You can see here at the top that the group 1 is turning on and off. That way you can momentarily deactivate all the hacks and take full control of your push as if PushHacker wasn't even there. This obviously will be very useful on stage. So I'll see you again in the next tutorial about the PushHacker, where I'll demonstrate the clip function, which can turn your push into a looper device.